All right, today we're working on this Pontiac GTO. It's got a 2JZ swap in it, of all things, which is pretty gnarly. We love it. So, yeah, thing's pretty cool. Check it out. All right, here's this GTO. Said it's a Haltech ECU car. It's got an IC7 dash in it. I'll check that out more when I get over there, but this thing is cool, man. It's super well done. 2JZ swap deal. It's got a I believe that's a 7483 EFR. I think those are the numbers for it. Something like that. It's a 78 pound a minute capable charger. It is a stock bottom end deal still. It's still VVTI, obviously. Tell by the cam cover there. Got some ID 1700s in it. It is flex fuel. I just got done with the pump gas stuff. It made like 460 something on like 17 pounds on pump gas. So goal here is to make just over 600 wheel for Abel. But look at all the detail. Look at the brackets he made to mount like the wideband controller and the fuse box for the Haltech. Over here, he's got the four port controller on it with a little bracket as well. The nylon hose stuff. It's just done really well. It's a nice piece. Yeah, so show you the dashboard a second. Looks, you know, your IC7 all tucked up in there. This is a, I believe he told me this is a T56 trans car currently. Yeah, I'm gonna dive into this thing, get some of the drivability sorted out. There is a couple issues there, and see what we can make for power. I mean, like I said, the goal is pretty modest. I think we'll be able to make that relatively safely, I would say, would be the right term for that. But yeah, gonna dive into it and see what happens. Goal was to make, like I said, 600 wheel. We made 630 horsepower, 517 foot-pounds of torque. Here's the graph. This was 27 or so here, 26 dip here, and then 27 again up top. If you check out the torque curve here, I'll move this out of the way. See how it hits and falls. I tried pulling some of that spike out of it. Using the four port, I'm moving around like 0.5% of duty cycle. It's super sensitive. That's up to 7,800 there. We could turn it harder, but we already met his goals for the combo, so we're going to leave it there for a while, and then we'll turn it up down the road when he's ready for a bit more. That's really it for this one. These things sound awesome. It's hard not to love the sound of a straight six, specifically, you know, the 2Js, but all straight sixes in general pretty much sound amazing, so definitely like working on it. Going to get this thing off of here and work on the next one.